estate remains a rare sight on UK roads. Can you remember the last time you saw one? Of course. This may be down to the fact that its styling is so similar to its larger Passat stablemate. Unless the two cars are sitting side by side, it can be difficult to tell them apart. Depending on which version of the Golf Estate you choose, you get different suspension setups. Less powerful versions have a fairly basic rear suspension, slightly more powerful versions have a more sophisticated setup at the rear, while the sporty versions get various arrangements that are lowered and stiffened to varying degrees. There's plenty of engine choice in the Golf Estate range. The most affordable of these is the diminutive 1.0-litre petrol engine. It's not particularly quick, but it's a lot perkier than you might expect, and with plenty of flexibility thrown in, it makes it a very easy car to live with. Further up the petrol range are turbocharged 1.4 and 1.5-litre engines, both of which are quick and wonderfully smooth. Of all the powertrains on offer, the latest 1.5-litre petrol is probably the pick of the range. It is prone to the odd stumble as you come on and off the throttle at low revs. No doubt a byproduct of limiting emissions, but in truth, it's unlikely anyone will take issue with this. The rest of the time, the engine is creamy smooth, with a strong lust for revs and an impressively linear power delivery right up to the red line. Diesel choices start with a 1.6-litre unit, which is very flexible if not all that quick, and it could be quieter and smoother, too. The 2.0-litre diesels address these issues, are much more flexible, and throw in a fair bit of extra pace.